Lastly, let's try some more complicated ones so you can see how to put all these rules together to solve more challenging geometric situations. How am I going to work out the size of angle A here? Well, if I knew this angle, let's call it P, I could use P and 83 degrees to work out A. Can I work out P? Of course, it's vertically opposite that 30 degrees, so P must also be 30 degrees. Now 30 plus 83 is 113, so A must be 67 degrees. See how we worked our way backwards from the angle we wanted to the information we were given? We used the context of the problem to work out a path from what we knew to what we wanted to find out. Let's try another. How can I work out angle B here? Now, you might be tempted to say it's co-interior with this angle here, and plenty of my students have tried that before, let me assure you. But you need to look more carefully at the problem. These two lines are not parallel, so that won't work. But if I knew this angle, let's give it a name, Q, then B and Q would be supplementary. Can I work out Q? Of course I can. It's an interior angle opposite this external angle. So Q must be 124 minus 41, which is 83 degrees. And then B must be 180 minus 83, which is 97 degrees. Remember to always draw the codes for the rules you used, so others can follow your reasoning. Okay, can you find a way to work out angle C here? Take a moment to look at the diagram. Work backwards from your goal. What do you need to know to work out C? Well, if I knew this angle, let's call it R, then I could use the angle sum for the quadrilateral to work out C. And R is on a straight line with this 74 degrees, so R must be 106 degrees. Then 106 plus 110 plus 90 makes 306, leaving 54 degrees for C. The last two include some parallel lines. Can we use them to help us find a solution? Again, look at the goal and work your way out from there until you get to something you can work out. D and this angle, let's call it U, are co-interior. And U and this 27 degrees are complementary because they're in a right angle. So U must be 63 degrees. And D must be 117 degrees. I can see two solutions for E. These two angles and E are co-interior. Or these two angles are alternate, and then the angles inside the triangle are supplementary. Notice that you're going to do the same operations no matter which way you think your way through the problem. Let's use the first method. 30 and 25 add to 55 degrees, so E must be 125 degrees. Happy problem solving!